Hey everybody, it is Gordon Majak here, back with another episode of Timeless Pop, Rock, and Soul. And just like yesterday, as was the case with the great Tina Turner yesterday, we are back again today with another one of the all-time great female soul singers. And no joke, folks, I am talking about not only one of my personal favorites, but one of the real all-time queens in pop, rock, and soul singing. You want to know who I'm talking about? Couldn't wait to get to her on the channel here. Took a little while, 100 and some videos, but man, we will be coming back to this lady several more times on the channel. From 1973, here's our album, and what an album this was. I was just looking at some of the songs off of this album. Ridiculous. This is, of course, Gladys Knight and the Pips, the Imagination album, 1973. What a record. I'll get to the particulars of the songs here, but man, this album was just a monster. Now, check this out. You know, you may think of Gladys Knight just sort of as having her big 70s heyday there, and that being sort of the extent of her career. And that would be understandable because Gladys sure did have one heck of a heyday there in the 70s, and we'll get to the details of that in just a second. But actually, I was a little surprised to see when I started looking into her career a little more closely. I was pretty surprised to see just how far back she went with the Pips there making music. And they went back further than I thought, and they had more success in the really early days of their career, well before the 70s, that I was not as aware of as well. So let me give you just a quick background. Actually, let's do this. We're going to talk about Gladys Knight, of course, the great singer. And we're also going to talk about some of these songs. But just before I forget, I don't want to forget this. Let's give a proper tip of the cap and the proper amount of respect due to the Pips, because it's easy to talk about Gladys Knight and forget about the three dudes back there that were just cutting up the floor with those groovy dance moves and those incredible background vocals on so many of these Gladys Knight and the Pips hit songs, classic songs. So let's give our proper respects here to the Pips very quickly before we move over to some of these great songs that the Pips killed on those background vocals. We have William Guest, Edward Patton, and then, of course, Gladys Knight's brother, Bubba Knight. So Bubba Knight, Edward Patton, and William Guest, the Pips. You only get one of those in a lifetime, folks. And Gladys got the Pips, and there they were back there singing those great backgrounds and making those moves and dressed like a million bucks and this the whole thing, man. The Pips, that was sort of synonymous with that move, that moving and grooving with the background singers, wasn't it? All right, let's talk about the Gladys Knight in the Pips, because this is what I discovered when I went back and looked at her career. Listen to this. I'm going to list off seven songs spanning from 1961, her first one, and then 1974 will be the last one. So check this out. Between 1961 and 1974. In 1961, Gladys Knight and the Pips had a song called Every Beat of My Heart. Number one on the R&B chart in 1961. Okay, this is way before I thought their career really got started. Okay, Every Beat of My Heart, a number one R&B song in 1961. Second up here, how about their original version back there in the old Motown days of Heard It Through the Grapevine? Do you remember the great Gladys Knight and the Pips version of Heard It Through the Grapevine? That's in 1967. That is a number one R&B hit, folks. They've got two number one R&B hits under their belt, and we're still in the mid-60s there, okay? And Heard It Through the Grapevine also got up to number two on the pop chart, all right? How about in 1970? We're 9 years in now. It's been 9 years since that first number one R&B song. Well, they're back with another one. Boom. Here's their third number one R&B song in 1970, the classic. If I Were Your Woman, man, oh man, what a song that was. And remember how George Michael later on there in his career did a really cool cover of that as well. I think he called it If You Were My Woman. But yeah, Gladys Knight and the Pips, the original If I Were Your Woman, that's a number one R&B song in 1970, number 9 on the pop chart. Their last big hit for Motown there. Now we're up to 1973. This is now a 12-year span of time since their first number one R&B tune. And in 1973, they dropped just one of the all-timers, man. Another one of not only a Motown classic, but a decade classic, a genre classic, just a defining pop song. And that was the classic Neither One of Us. Remember that one by Gladys Knight and the Pips? Another number one R&B song and a number two pop record. All right. So that's where we're going to pause the story for a second, because that's where our next batch of songs, okay, they are in quite a roll here. They've got four in the span of 12 years. Gladys Knight and the Pips have four number one R&B songs, and three of them are top 10 on the pop chart. All right. So here comes this album now in early 1973 on the heels of Neither One of Us, okay? Their last big Motown hit there. On the heels of that comes this album on their new label. Check out some of the singles that came off of this album. How about 1973? Of course, it's their signature song, Midnight Train to Georgia. There's their fifth number one R&B song and their first number one pop song. Here we go again, across the board, crossover smash. As why we say it is their signature and defining song. The highest moment of their commercial career, at least, for Gladys Knight and the Pips, The Midnight Train to Georgia, just an iconic song. And then we come to the song that we are going to be listening to next up on the list of smash singles by Gladys Knight and the Pips. And that's a song called I've Got to Use My Imagination. I think they just call it Imagination, but Gladys Knight's really got to use her imagination, and she's going to be doing that. Another number one R&B song there in 1973, late 1973, a top four song in the pop chart. By the time this one has run its course on the charts, they're going to release another single off of this album. It's also going to go to number one on the R&B chart, and it's also going to go top three on the pop chart. Just incredible crossover chart success for Gladys Knight and the Pips there. That's 1974, and that, of course, another immortal classic song, Best Thing That Ever Happened to Me. What an unbelievable run. This spans 13 years between 1961 and 1974. We're talking about five, top five pop songs, and all of those number one songs on the R&B side. And there is Gladys Knight right in the middle of it with the Pips. Just unbelievable. And let's talk about Gladys Knight here again. We're going to sound like a broken record from when we talked about Tina Turner yesterday. But Gladys Knight, another one of these singers, as I said, one of the real queens, one of the all-time greats there, and certainly one of my all-time favorites. And like Tina Turner and so many of the other great soul singers, Gladys Knight has got that full emotional spectrum there available to her, and so many different colors and nuances in her voice. And she can capture every emotion on the pendulum there, it seems like, as the moods swing back and forth in these songs and in these lyrics. And when she's being sweet and romantic, she can melt your heart. And when she's being strong and defiant, you better back up and keep your distance. And you get everything in between. Just so much strength and yet so much vulnerability. Here we go again. So much beauty and so much pain. All of that bittersweet. All of these things that I always talk about in the emotional spectrum. All of these moods and colors and emotions that are available to these great singers that they're able to draw from. And Gladys Knight, man, one of the all-timers, no doubt about that. She's right there with the all-time greats in the R&B and soul category, and deservedly so. And I'm not even talking about just because of these hit records. Just that voice and the resiliency and the soul in that voice and the life. There is so much, just as with Tina Turner, there is so much life lived in that voice, so much wisdom in that beautiful voice of Gladys Knight. I loved it all the way back there. I think I probably, if I were your woman, would have been, I would have been 12 years old with if I were your woman. And that would have been probably my introduction to Gladys Knight in the Pips, 1970, a huge hit record then. And then, of course, Neither One of Us and Midnight Train to Georgia. We all knew all of those as the hits just kept coming for Gladys Knight in the Pips. And all these years later, I hear on good authority that Gladys Knight still sounds fabulous every now and then when she does a live show, and I'm not even a bit surprised. She always had such an abundance of soul, and it seemed like such a deep reservoir to draw from there vocally, Gladys Knight. And of course, that instrument doesn't sound like anybody else. You've got a mix of the church and the street, and as I said, the pleasure and the pain and everything on that emotional spectrum. It's all right there for Gladys Knight, and she knows how to deliver it with maximum emotional effect. Man, if you cannot, if you can't listen to some of those classic Gladys Knight and the Pips songs and feel emotionally connected to some of those songs and some of those lyrics, listening to Gladys, you better check your heartbeat. Man, because Gladys will move you with her voice and with those great vocals on so many of these hit songs. And certainly that is the case on the one we are going to hear right now. Let me show you that album again. Imagination, I've got to use my imagination. As I said, number one R&B, number four on the pop chart. Remember this thing blasting out of the radio back there in late 73 and early 74. This was a great, just a smoking little track there for Gladys Knight, and a nice little diversion from some of the stuff that they had been doing there with some of those more recent hits and some of the ballads. So it was nice to see Gladys Knight and the Pips really lay this one down there in 73, and that's exactly what they did. Imagination, the album, Imagination, the song. It is Gladys Knight and the Pips, man, one of the queens. Come on, Gladys. Okay, we got to go back and hear that again. Did you hear when it goes from being... Gladys just gave me such a chill, man. Did you hear the way she just stepped up and took over on that section of the song after doing the nice group vocals there and playing off of the Pips? And then she just steps out in front on that line and with those vocals just takes over the entire song. Okay, we got to go back and hear that again. That was just ridiculous. Let's go back here. Come on. I mean, they're coming off of Midnight Train in Georgia, which is just one of the most iconic soul songs, not only the 70s, but of all the entire pop rock soul, huge category of popular music, right? One of the most iconic songs. They're coming off of Midnight Train to Georgia, and they just come out with Imagination and low. I mean, it's just low down. I mean, all the way down. The bottom end on this groove just pumping. And Gladys Knight steps out front there and just takes charge. And man, laying down the law, Matt, this sounded so good back in 1973. A little bit of an uncharacteristic sound, but just throwing it down. Gladys, come on. God, that is just filthy. Okay, that is just low down funky rock and roll, folks. This is just rock and roll. Put them in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. If they're not in there already, they need to be the rock and roll, whatever you need to put them. Put Gladys Knight in the Pips in there. That is just throwing down rock and roll. And if you thought the Gladys Knight and the Pips were just going to come in and do all this pretty romantic stuff with these beautiful background vocals and the nice suits and the dance moves, you know, yeah, they can bring all that stuff too. But don't be mistaken, Gladys will step out there with that microphone and those Pips will get busy back there on the attitude. That's the coolest thing about so many of these backgrounds. It's not just that they're doing it and they're doing the moves and of course the whole presentation. But that's what's so cool about so many of their backgrounds. And this song just shows it A plus. It's the attitude, the attitude in those backgrounds, man. And they are working Gladys. They are making her stay honest on her vocals. And of course, she does the same for them. What an incredible synergy. And it might be easy sometimes to overlook the backup singers, but in the case of Gladys Knight in the Pips, please do not do that, man. They had some seamless chemistry going on there between Gladys and the Pips. Just working that rock and roll. Come on, man. That is a low down dirty groove right there. And yeah, imagine that thundering out of the speakers in the club. I may have actually slipped that in the dance club there at some point. You just never know when I was going to pull something like that out. Look at some of these songs. I mean, these are just iconic songs, you know. Even, of course, Marvin Gaye did such a great version of Heard It Through the Grapevine, but that came later. But that original Gladys Knight and the Pips version of Heard It Through the Grapevine, a classic. If I Were Your Woman, Neither One of Us. I mean, that's one of the all-time heartbreak ballads right there, Neither One of Us. Midnight Train to Georgia, just, a classic. This one, just throwing it down. Best thing that ever happened to me. There's the follow-up to this one. There's another just beautiful ballad. Such a sweet song. Such a gorgeous song. And what a career for Gladys Knight and the Pips, man. Gladys, one of those vocals, just like Aretha, just like Chaka Khan, just like Tina Turner. Man, you could never get Gladys out of your heart and out of your soul, because some of these vocal performances, well, all of these vocal performances, and even so many more, of course, this is just a handful of their biggest hits that I'm talking about. So many legendary vocal performances from Gladys Knight, and such a unique sound, such a unique perspective, and she is just one of those essential singers to me that I cannot imagine talking about the great R&B soul singers, male or female, male and female, whatever, and not including Gladys Knight right there at the top of the list, one of the real queens. And to see the Pips, it was so cool to see them having done that and had success over a much bigger span of time than I would have thought, going all the way back to the early 60s there. So a job exceedingly well done, as I say, from time to time there. Gladys Knight and the Pips. Imagination, man, that track thundering, that is just a locomotive thundering down the track. They leave Motown and they go over to Buddha there, and they pump out this album, all these classic songs. Man, that was a record to have there in the early 70s. Gladys Knight and the Pips, hope you like that one. Oh, we're coming back with another one. We've got a little bit more of this 70s soul stuff that we got to talk about. You'll see soon enough. Thank you, Gladys. Man, one of the queens. She's right there, folks. Love Gladys. Really got to you.